Welcome back. He is our resident money man. We're talking about Mike Eppel. We're going to bring him in with a look at business. And the money also comes with having to pay back the money. You're working through those numbers this morning. Good morning to you, Mike.
Yeah, good morning, Melanie. So interesting story in the Financial Post this morning about, you know, how we've been seeing the federal government day to day offer up emergency assistance programs, and the spending levels on that are now fast approaching about $160 billion. The big question going forward here, as the restrictions are slowly lifted and as the job market comes back, again, very slowly and to what extent, we don't know. How are the federal how is the federal government going to pull back on some of those programs that are currently out there? Do they have to be reduced, extended, you know, tweaked in some way, shape, or form? And what's adding to the complexity of it is the fact that before the pandemic struck, Canadian household debt levels were already sky high. And that was laid bare by the fact that as soon as the economy was shut down, how many people immediately had trouble paying the bills on a monthly basis, right? So the challenges are very much extreme, I suppose, for any government right now. Household debt level, you know, for any country was pretty high going into this thing. So it's going to be interesting to see how this works its way through and what governments do, again, to wean the economy off of some of the stimulus efforts.
I've got a couple of really interesting stories in here. Not that that wasn't interesting. That is very interesting and very important, Mike. But I always ask people this question. How long are you willing to wait in line for something? Mm-hmm. Sometimes you have no choice. Let's say it's a grocery store and you got to get in there and get your essentials. But how long are you willing to wait in line?
Not long.
Yeah, me neither.
my wife and I, this is anecdotal. My wife and I were out yesterday just running a couple of errands, and we're just driving along. And you look at a store, line up, nope. Mm-hmm. Line up, nope.
Yep.
Nope. Don't need it, can wait, you know, and I think that's kind of what people are faced with now. It's like, okay, do you need to line up for certain things? You just go online, do the e-commerce thing, and it's a rethink, a reset on consumer spending, isn't it? Maybe the stuff that you were interested in buying previously, you're not so much anymore. Now, that's not to say there isn't pent-up demand for certain things. Again, anecdotally, we as a family are into camping, and want to get the trailer ready for things. And we were talking to our local RV dealership, and they were really busy on the first day that they reopened. Auto dealerships, right? Same thing. They're starting to get calls again. So, again, it's going to be interesting to see exactly how the retail space adapts to this new normal. And, you know, and wearing face masks, too, and all this other stuff that you got. It just feels weird, right?
It does. It's all weird. Tough to get used to. Well, when you bring up the masks thing, and I know we've all experienced this, anyone who has an iPhone, you're wearing your mask, right? The facial recognition, not working, the phone's not opening, it's not opening.
Who are you?
Right, who is this person? So you always take it down, then it comes up. Now, Apple recognizes this is a bit of an issue, they're working on
it. Yeah, basically, it immediately jumps to the passcode. It's not a perfect fix, but the iOS update that came out yesterday doesn't freeze the phone up and continue to try for the face ID because it can't recognize it because you're wearing a mask. And if you don't pull it down, then it still doesn't function. So you go immediately to the pass. It's sort of back to the way phones used to work with a passcode as opposed to face ID, isn't it?
Weird.
Yeah.
Weird how things, but we just get used to this technology, right?
Well, you know, it's like we were supposed to get rid of plastic and now we have to use plastic and right, all this stuff. It's topsy-turvy.
Some of it has gone backwards. Some of it has gone forward and some of it will evolve. Yeah. So we'll look at it that way.
That is right.
Manufacturing. Let's talk a little bit about that and Ford.
Yeah, Ford Motor Company restarted their plants in the States and here in Canada, and slow rollout, and immediately yesterday had to shut down two facilities. Because one person in a line in Chicago, outside Chicago, one person in the plant came down or tested positive for COVID-19. Whole facility shut down. Parts supplier, same thing. So, you know, this is the struggle that manufacturers are going to face here. What do you do to keep COVID out of the plant, and how aggressive do you have to be, again, to keep other employees safe? If, again, and just one person comes down with it and tests positive, the ripple effects are at a magnitude level.
Significant, absolutely. Mike, we have run out of time, but as always, lovely to chat with you.
Thank you.
We'll talk to you soon.
Thanks.